Now it is about the migrant workers. Now, the migrant workers has always remained at the socio-economic margins of our society, and they are silently serving as an instrumental labor force of urban economies. The pandemic has brought them into a national focus. On announcement of countrywide lockdown, a very large number of migrant workers decided to move back from their places of employment to their native villages. But there was non-availability of transport. It has created its own problem. Added to this was the fear of starvation and inconvenience to their families. This caused the migrant workers to demand wages and transport facilities for returning to their villages. Their mental agony was accentuated by multiple factors such as sudden loss of livelihood, possibility of lack of food, inability to assist in harvesting their rabi crop due to not being able to reach home in time. Reports of inadequate response of some districts in providing the essential boarding and lodging arrangements along the way multiplied their fears. This is all what you read in the newspapers during the period of lockdown. You have learned many lessons from the situation when you are tasked to oversee the functioning of district disaster relief force in your district. In your opinion, what ethical issues arose in the current migrant crisis? What do you understand by ethical caregiving state? What assistance can a civil society render to mitigate the sufferings of migrants in similar situations? So this is what asked in the question. So again, before starting this, see, when you are reading about any social issue, see here, during the period of lockdown, we have experienced the crisis of migrant laborers. At that time, so many newspaper articles, be it Hindu or Indian Express, has written about this topic from an ethical perspective also. For example, I'll tell you one thing. There were, for example, when these migrant laborers were entering UP and Bihar, we have something called this sodium hypochlorite. This was actually used as a disinfectant of a physical surfaces. But the same spray was sprayed on these migrant laborers to disinfect them. They were merely treated as a physical entity. Not just forget about this humanity or dignity aside. They were merely treated as something called physical entities. Most of you have even seen this image, I think. So many laborers were asked to sit, and these municipal workers were spraying the sodium hypochlorite solution on them, merely to disinfect them. So these were the pictures. Hope you remember. If you could quote that situation as it is in the introduction, it will give you many marks. So in the introduction itself, sodium hypochlorite, a solution that was used to disinfect the surface, has been used to disinfect people, migrant people who have migrated from their workplace to UP and Bihar by the municipal workers. So even if you write this sentence in the introduction, it will touch the heart of the examiner. So what is the social contract theory? The social contract theory is about the state and citizens have come into an agreement. What is that agreement? We as citizens are submitting few amount of our rights to you so that there is a law and order prevails in the society, so that the state takes care of the citizens or people. But what happened during this lockdown period? Does the state took care of all the people? No. State took care of the people who are rich, who are educated, but not who are migrant or who are workers. So a state which is run by the will of majority is Leviathan. This is nothing but a sea monster which eats all other things. This is what Thomas Hobbes had said. So I'm bringing the, either you can quote that live incident in the introduction, or you can quote the social contract theory that you study in the theories aspect or the philosopher's aspect. That a state which is run by the will of majority, during the lockdown period, had the government inquired, asked about, did it thought about the plight of migrants? It simply decided to announce lockdown based on the reports of the educated, based on the reports of the doctors, based on the reports of the people who are scientists who are more educated than. It did not bother to ask, or did not bother to think from the ground level of the people who are poor. Yes, you can follow me. You can write it. Absolutely. Can we begin with the child beside dead mother and partner during? You can write it. See, when you are able to quote that realistic situations in the introduction, it will touch the heart of the examiner and you will definitely get good marks. but provided you also try to connect it with the thinker. So in social contract theory, it is all about the people. We all people have come together. We have agreed that we'll create a state and we will submit some amount of rights to that state so that there will be prevailing law and order in the society, so that the state takes care of the citizens. But in the lockdown period, what happened? It took care of only those people who are rich. It took care of those people who are well educated. So here the state has been run as per the will of majority. By majority, I mean who wielded the power, who had the voice. Then it is called Leviathan. So like this, you have to introduce, like this, you have to link. Now, this COVID-19 pandemic cannot be defeated by Leviathan. It cannot be defeated by this monster or few people. But what we require is that this empowered population, we need everyone, everyone, provided we need empowered populace. So it was the duty of the government, it was the duty of the state to empower those migrant laborers, but it did not do so. So what were the ethical issues involved here? Now, this freedom of the people, their fundamental right, their Article 21 has been curtailed. There has been clear-cut discrimination, prejudice, catcalling. What is this catcalling? See, these migrant laborers were called infection carriers rather than calling them as affected. Now, with respect to risk, social distancing was physical distancing. But in case of these migrant laborers, the social distancing has been turned into something called untouchability. There was fear of stigmatization, and these migrant laborers, they feared that they will be stigmatized. Even then, there was some amount of health issue in them. Even then, they were facing health issues. They did not seek their health care. They silently suffered. So this wording, instead of this infection carriers, rather than calling them as affected, the social distancing has something has turned into a fear of stigmatization. Now the society and government has failed in their collective responsibility. We as well as government have failed in our responsibility. See, it is the migrant laborers that construct roads, railway bridges in your place, not your local laborer, wherever you are. Most often it is the migrant laborers. So COVID-19 has clearly highlighted the class bias built in government policies. When announcing lockdown, it took into the consideration of the educated, the rich, but not the poor. Now, it has clearly differentiated between privileged as well as poor. Here, first of all, you need to remember that this COVID-19 has been brought into the country by the rich, the so-called who can afford to travel on airplane. But who has been this effect, the burden has been suffered by maximum amount, this impact has been felt by the poor. This privileged had so-called the option of working from home. For the poor, the question of survival itself, which has resulted in hundreds and kilometers of walking. They are seen as mere factors of production. So these are all the ethical issues. There has been inequality in the access to information, resources, and healthcare. There has been clear lack of sympathy, empathy, and compassion. Now, I will write this traditional Yajmani system. I don't know if any one of you are from anthropology or sociology optional, you are clearly aware of this system that has been working traditionally in the villages. See, this Yajmani system is nothing but there is a patron or owner and there is a servant. Now, between these two people, there is some amount of emotional bondage. Even when there is some amount of failure of crop for this servant or any other difficulty, this patron or owner used to provide them, used to help him. But there has been some amount of human bonding in them. But when the lockdown has been announced, the government has been pleading the employers of these migrant laborers. They has been requesting them to take care of them. Yet they did not pay them. Yet they did not take care of them. And suddenly it has resulted in huge human cry. So this emotional or human bonding has been missing today. And it has been clearly visible during the time of lockdown. Yeah, Pulom is socially optional. Yes, I think you are aware of this Yajmani system. You can code the system. So these are all the ethical issues that you can write with respect to this case study. And what is the role of CSO? This is a simple question. They can mobilize the resources. They can provide immediate relief or protective gear, supporting the government, identifying the hotspots. All these things you can write. This is not a big issue. part, I mean, this is the easier part of this case study. This is a simple GSR. Now, what should be our conclusion? Now, the 5 R's to prevent another migrant crisis: recognize, register, responsibility, ration cards, and residence. These all things should be provided to the migrant laborers. So, this should be our conclusion. Yeah, so this is the last slide. Yeah, this should provide another. If you have any doubts, please raise your doubts in the chat box. Ashok, Khushbu, Polomi, Rahul. Is the way I'm discussing, is it comprehensive, or do you want me to make any other changes? Can we write counterpoints in both positive note and negative note? And to what, I mean, Ashok, I did not get you. To what counterpoints and to what aspect you want to write these counterpoints? Can you please elaborate, Ashok? And like environmental impact sustaining. To which case study you are asking me about this migrant crisis? Is it migrant crisis and fifth case study? Is 50K studies about migrant or something else? APW. Ashok, is it about APW or migrant crisis? Okay, APW, like environmental impacts. See, but the thing is that, it's all about imaginary, whether that industry is resulting in any other environmental impact or it is causing any harm is not provided in the case study. So that is the reason why I was a little bit careful in writing these negative points. Even I don't want to write this plastic as a sin industry. See, suppose we don't know whether it is a plastic, I mean positive in terms of plastic, that is, it is recycling more plastic than what it is producing. So all this is imaginary. In the case study, everything it is imaginary. That is not clearly said whether it is result. Further, it is stated that he has used these people during the time of lockdown in planting of trees. So he is leaving a positive impact on the environment. Did you get my point, Ashok? So see, this is a rare incident. So it's all imaginary. So that's why I did not take it to very extreme. There is not even a small point or small thing where you can pick or you can comment on a negative aspect or negative terms. Okay, still Khushbu, Palomi, Rahul, any doubts? See, is it okay for the way I am dealt with the case studies, or you want me to make any changes? Is it comprehensive? Did you find the same way elsewhere or any other place? Yeah, thank you, students. With this, I'll close this session.